We identified two modules, Lisa Schuster's in sociology and also Alice Block in sociology, who had some ideas around activities they wanted to run with their students, but they weren't sure how to do it previously. For Lisa's module specifically, she wanted to move away from giving the students a 4,000 word essay at the end of term and actually build in an activity that supported their essay writing skills as they went along. What we did was we used Moodle to provide the students with these portfolios that had a template that they completed each week after class and after they'd done their reading that Lisa could then go back in and comment on, which meant that the students got continuous feedback throughout the term and didn't have to kind of hand something in and then get all this feedback at the end after it was too late. With Alice's course, we were looking at submission specifically because it's a large cohort, 150 students, and previously, in terms of checking for plagiarism or just bad practice in essay writing, what had happened was students had submitted to Blackboard, and then if they thought that there was something off about it, they'd then download the essays out of Blackboard and submit to Tenton. What we did was we automated that process so that when students submitted their assignments, they automatically went into Turnitin. And actually the originality score and the ability to mark them online was actually displayed within the Moodle course. Well, historically at City, I mean, we've had a VLE for a long time, and what was happening was it was being used as an administrative tool because academics weren't necessarily getting involved, mostly due to time constraints and the usual kind of problems. But what we wanted to do was actually use Moodle as a teaching and learning tool to try and get around some of those problems, to help save time, to help support learning activities, and to create more of a teaching and learning, a set of teaching and learning tools online. So by involving the academics with the pilots, what we were hoping was to actually create some of those learning activities, which was a really good opportunity for us. Yeah, mostly it met my expectations. It was extremely user-friendly, it was flexible, attractive, the students liked the way it looked, felt as the academics. But there was, as with any new system, I think, a few technical glitches, and you sort of just have to bear with that, I think. I think Lisa and Alice were both really positive about the project. Alice actually pushed for it to be rolled out across the whole of sociology because she found it much more user-friendly than City Space. And Lisa, we got a lot of positive feedback from the students around the portfolio project that we did, which was really encouraging. We got some really positive feedback, as I said, from Lisa's course, in that the students said that they'd actually wished that they could have done this earlier in their university careers. We're now looking at an exercise as part of PDP week for first years that's along similar lines, because what they were saying was that it was really good feedback into how to write essays and actually how to structure them and what it was we were asking from them in terms of reflection and critical thought and being able to kind of compare and contrast different views. Mm. And that wasn't something that they felt they'd necessarily been taught before. Mm. I think the student feedback and the positive niche from the academics. Obviously, we started off with several small-scale pilots across the two schools. I think we had one module in most departments and only two in sociology. And actually, that the uptake has been huge for September, possibly more than we can handle, based on those pilots. The students have been extremely positive about them, I think, and I also think that the administrators have also been incredibly positive about them, because there's a lot that we've built in that's hopefully going to save them a lot of time as well. I think we have to, there's obviously going to be changes because we're going from small scale pilots to large scale implementation, but I think that we've got a good support network in place for September, and I'm interested and excited to see what people are going to do with it next year. Mostly to be patient and flexible, to find the time to work with academics on a one-to-one basis, so that you've actually got time to assess their needs, because everybody's different, everyone teaches in a different way, and everyone has different ideas around what your role as a learning technologist supporting their project should be as well, and to actually be flexible with those and work with academics, I think, is the key.